So let's face it, we all spend way too much time staring at our smartphones. Between work, email, text messaging, social media, and playing app games, we are looking at our phones all day long. With new statistics showing that worldwide, we're spending over 6.5 hours a day staring at our screens. That means the average person will stare at their screen for over 3 months out of a given year. And that definitely contributes to eye problems, with one study showing an incidence of digital eye strain at over 78%. But now, this just came out. This is the TCL 40 Next paper, and happens to be the first smartphone with a screen specifically designed to reduce digital eye strain and to be more eye healthy. But what is so different about it? And can screen technology like this really help with the eyes? So today we're going to examine how smartphones affect our eyes through the lens of what this technology brings to the table. And hopefully that'll help us better understand how this technology could help and give us an idea of how smartphones and other digital screens will change going into the future. So shout out to TCL for sponsoring this video and giving us an opportunity to have a deeper look at this new technology and how smartphones affect the eyes. Okay, so if you first start to think about how smartphones could affect the eyes, most of us will undoubtedly think of the dreaded blue light. But while blue light does play an important role in this puzzle, there are other influencing factors. Now, the first way that phone screens affect our eyes, and that I think people see but don't realize, is how much glare comes off of the screen. By glare, this means any reflected light bouncing off of the screen itself and hitting you in the eyes. But glare also includes directionality, or the scattering of light coming through the smartphone screen itself. And this glare or level of light scatter can dramatically reduce contrast, making viewing of the screen much more difficult, often making us try to squint our eyes or try to even work harder to view the screen accurately. And this glare is known to be one of the major factors contributing to digital eye strain. Now, looking at this new phone from TCL, you can easily tell a huge difference in glare versus other screens. It turns out that they use some sort of specialized chemical etching that creates a nano level of roughness, and that produces kind of a paper-like matte effect of texture. And because of that, it helps scatter the internal light source of what you're viewing on the screen, making it appear softer, while simultaneously diffusing any reflected light from an external light source, drastically reducing reflections by a whopping 90%. And this in turn creates a softer visual experience and makes it easier to view the screen, even in outdoor environments. I've seen a few other like matte screen technologies in things like TVs and other computer monitors, but I've never seen it in a smartphone before, but I think they are honestly onto something here. Interestingly, and I'll kind of just throw this in here, even though it's off of the discussion of how screens affect the eyes, just this matte feel, tactile feeling of the screen is honestly really cool. It does feel like paper. Okay, now beyond just glare, there are different types of phone screens, and this phone has what's called Next Paper mode, which comes in two options, both color paper and ink paper, which by using a combination of both hardware and software, the display turns into an e-reader. And this feature is honestly something that makes me pretty happy, because if you've ever used an e-reader before, it feels very different to your eyes. An e-reader just doesn't cause the same level of eye strain as other types of screens do. And over the last few weeks while I've been testing it out, I've mainly kept it in color paper mode, which I do find is way more comfortable. It's less harsh on my eyes. The ink paper mode basically just turns it into a black and white mode, which I think will probably be best if you are doing a lot of book reading, articles, and checking emails, that sort of thing. But either way, I think it's really cool how you can just turn it into this mode and basically do anything on your phone, whether it be checking emails, playing games, watching videos even, and just everything. Everything looks and feels like an e-reader. Okay, now let's dive into this whole blue light issue. This is something that I get a lot of questions about from patients in the clinic, and is something I've kind of touched on in a few other videos. If you haven't heard, much of the light that is emitted from our digital screens comes from the blue wavelength light zone. And this is concerning because blue light has a shorter wavelength, but it has a much higher energy. And contrary to the popular belief, there's in fact two different types of blue light. There is good blue light, and there is bad blue light. This definition comes from the International Commission on Non-Ionizing Radiation Protection, which defines the more concerning and high-energy blue light being between 415 and 455 nanometers of light, with the more beneficial blue light ranging from 460 to 500 nanometers of light. The more beneficial blue light is known to affect more of our neurological functions, most notably that of our sleep cycles. And this occurs because of a specialized cell within the back of the eye called an intrinsically photosensitive retinal ganglion cell. And that cell is highly sensitive to wavelengths of blue light, which then sends non-visual information from the eye through the optic nerve to other parts of your brain, which is known to play an influence on both your alertness as well as your sleep cycles, with some studies showing that blue light can influence our ability to pay attention as well as be used in light-based treatments for things like SAD or seasonal affective disorder. Now, the major concerns with the bad blue light is that it can potentially damage retinal cells in the back of the eye, mainly when it comes from a high energy source, such as the sun, a laser, or even from certain powerful LED lights, as they've been able to show this in animal studies. However, and thankfully, they've been able to calculate and show that the amount of energy of blue light emitted from our digital screens is not enough to be a direct biohazard to the retina in the back of the eye. That's why we don't burn holes in the back of our eye just from staring at your screen like we do when we stare at the sun. But in addition to all of this, this bad blue light is also known to be more neurologically stimulating, which can trigger migraines for some people. And this type of blue light is known to focus differently inside of the eye and scatter more, leading to more problems with visual glare and starbursts, which make it not only more difficult to see, but causes more visual discomfort. So, now with all this knowledge on blue light, what is TCL doing differently with the next paper phone here? First, they found a way to fine-tune the screen's blue light spectrum, allowing the blue light range to remain between 457 to about 462.5 nanometers, which is a less energy-dense range of blue light, effectively reducing the blue light known to influence our eyes by about 61%. They were able to do this, keeping the good, beneficial blue light without changing color tones. So that means the phone doesn't have to look bright yellow or orange to reduce the amount of blue light. And I think that's probably one of the biggest challenges for a lot of these tech companies when it comes to blue light is that they're trying to have both the beneficial blue light, get rid of the bad blue light, but not have the screen like turn a dark orange color. They're trying to keep a good balance of all the natural colors. Okay, so let's ask the question of, do smartphones hurt the eyes? Well, to answer that, we have to look at digital eye strain as a whole. The symptoms of digital eye strain include eye fatigue, eye pain, blurred vision, headache, dry eyes, and even neck and shoulder pain. With many of these symptoms stemming from overuse and the challenge of trying to maintain focus for long periods of time on something that is so close to your face, with most people on average holding their phone only about 8 inches away from their eyes. And this puts a very high demand on the eye focusing systems and the micro adjustments that your eyes need to make to maintain good visibility. And this often results in that eye ache and kind of tired eye feeling that you experience. And while it's a little bit outside of this video, there are concerns that excessive amounts of near device use could be increasing the risk for myopia or nearsightedness in children. But take all of that and then add in poor posture, poor contrast from the letters in the background of the screen, bad glare from the screen itself, plus the reflections off of the screen, and then poor lighting conditions. All of which pushes your eyes to focus harder on the screen, which in turn reduces your blink rate by about 60%, as well as decreasing your blink amplitude, which means that when you're focusing on a screen, you tend not to blink your eyes as often, and you usually don't blink them completely, which means that your eyes are open all the time, your tear film dries out, and you get bad dry eye symptoms. And there is some concern that increased screen use could be contributing to the risk of dry eye disease. Now, of course, with all of these advancements, I think it's possible somebody could start to make the argument that with such a reduction in glare and reduction in blue light and the use of next paper mode, could that help reduce how much we hyper-focus on our smartphone screens? And therefore, maybe somebody's blink rate wouldn't be as affected. And so not only would you have a reduction in maybe digital eye strain, a reduction in all the harsh blue light exposure, but then also perhaps dry eye symptoms would improve as well. These are, of course, just my curiosity thoughts, but something I would definitely like to see a study on. Now, of course, digital screens do bring tons of convenience to our daily lives, but they do also come with some concerns, too. I do think we should all start to think a little bit more about things like glare and blue light and eye strain and the way it affects our lives. And in that regard, I do feel that what TCL has put together here is the most advanced smartphone screen that I've personally ever seen. And especially considering the fact that these phones, like the TCL Next Paper 40 here, only comes in at about $170 US, with the 5G version coming in at only about $240 US, means that you're basically getting one of the most advanced smartphone screens in basically like a budget-friendly phone. Which honestly just gives me a lot of hope for kind of better adoption and kind of the spread and use of this type of technology. But let me pass this off to you. What kind of challenges do you face when it comes to dealing with eye strain? And let me know your thoughts about this screen technology down in the comments. Either way, huge shout out and thanks again to TCL for sponsoring this video, just giving us a chance to get a deep dive on what they're doing with this new technology and how phone screens affect our eyes. As always, I'll put additional links in the description below so you can check this out yourself. Otherwise, thank you so much for watching. Keep an eye on it. And we'll see you in that next video, hopefully with less eye strain.